Hello kids, in this video we will learn to calculate duration of days. Duration of days means number of days between two events. For example, you went to your nanny's place on 5th of September and came back on 10th of September. So the number of days you stayed at your nanny's place is known as the duration of days. Like in this case, you stayed there for 5 days. So this 5 days is known as the duration of days. In this video, we will learn how to calculate this duration of days. For this, we have few steps. Let's see those. The first step is, you need to know the number of days in each month. यानी हर एक महीने में कितने कितने दिन होते हैं ये आपको मालूम होना चाहिए. जैसे मई में 31 डेज हैं, बट फरवरी में 28 डेज हैं. Step 2 is find out if the year is leap year if February is involved. For example, your question has February in it, then you must know whether the year is leap year or not, because we know that in leap year February has 29 days instead of 28. But the step 3 is make a table showing number of days involved for the event. Now let's solve an example for calculating duration of days. Alicia and her family went for a trip on 4th September and came back on 15th October. Find out for how many days Alicia stayed there. So first we'll make a table like this. Then we will write down the months involved in the question. So let's read it again. She went on 4th September and came back on 15th October. That means the months involved are September and October. So September and October. Now we will find out the number of days of September and October. Now we know that in September we have 30 days. Also, the family went on 4th September. That means till 3rd they were there in the town only. They went on 4th. So the 4th September will be counted in their trip only. So the number of days of September that will be counted in their trip will be 30 minus 3, because they were there in the town for only 3 days. So we will do 30 minus 3 and this will give us as 27. So in the month of September they were there in the trip for 27 days. Now in the month of October they returned on 15th October. That means 15th ko wo apne ghar wapas aa chuke the. So we will not count 15th October in their trip day. So the number of days that will be counted in their trip from the month of October will be 14 days only. 14 days. Now we will add up all these. 27 plus 14 will give us 7 plus 4 is 11, carry 1, 2 plus 1 is 3, plus 1 equals to 4. So Alicia and her family was on the trip for 41 days. Now next is a table given in your book. This is a very important table. Please learn it. 7 days is equals to 1 week, 2 weeks is equals to 1 fortnight, that is 15 days. Now 52 weeks is equals to 1 year, 4 weeks is equals to 1 month, 365 days is equals to 1 year, 12 months is equals to 1 year, 10 years is equals to 1 decade, 100 years is equals to 1 century, 1000 years is equals to 1 millennium. This is a very important table as this will help you to solve your questions. So students, please learn this table. One more example. Aslam was 8 years old on October 7, 2014. In what year was he born? This is the first part of the question. We have to find his birth year. That means we can say the year in which he was 0 years old. How old will he be on October 7, 2019? Now this is the second part. In this we have to find out his age in the year 2019. So let's move towards first part. Now students, here we have to find out in which year he was born. That means in which year his age was 0 years old, because when a child is born he is 0 years old at that age. So look here, in 2014 he is 8 years old. Similarly, when we will go back 1 year, that means 2013, he must be 7 years old. 2012, 6 years old. Similarly, we will go back and we can find the birth year. So for this, what we have to we can do, we can simply subtract 8 from 2014. So 4 minus 8 not possible, we'll take carry from 1, it will become 0, 4 will become 14. Now 14 minus 8 is your 6, 0 will come 0, 0 and 2. So that means we got our answer as 2006. That means Aslam was born in the year 2006. Let's revise it from the beginning. From 2006 till 2014, 8 years passed. That's why in 2014, Aslam's age was 8 years old. Similarly, now we have to find out his age in 2019. So that means if we will find out the years passed from 2006 to 2019, we can get our answer. So for this, we can simply subtract 2006 from 2019. 2019 minus 2006, it will be your 13. That means Aslam is 13 years old in the year 2019.